Cameron Diaz is one of the most notoriously private celebrities, even before she and her husband Benji Madden announced the arrival of their daughter Radix at the beginning of this year. Despite the couple keeping their lives on the down low, we do know that they call a beautiful Beverly Hills mansion home. While the pair bought a Studio City house together a few years back, their main residence is a compound in the Hidden Valley neighborhood that Cameron bought back in 2010. We'll take a look at three of Cameron and Benji's properties, and they're all impressive. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. A tall, striking, blue-eyed, natural blonde, Cameron Diaz is a former actress, author, producer, and more, who left home at 16 to live in multiple places across the globe. When she returned to California at the age of 21, she was working as a model and auditioned for a big role in the 1994 film The Mask. To her amazement, and despite having no previous acting experience, she was cast as a female lead opposite Jim Carrey. She frequently appeared in comedies throughout her acting career while also earning recognition in dramatic films. Her resume includes a long list of roles starring in There's Something About Mary, the Charlie's Angels franchise, and much more. As of 2018, Cameron's films have grossed a total of over $3 billion, and she's proven to possess everything one needs to become one of Hollywood's most sought-after actresses. In 2015, Cameron married her other half-musician Benji Madden at their home in Beverly Hills. Benji is a singer, songwriter, producer, and the lead guitarist for the band Good Charlotte, which he played in for years alongside his twin Joel Madden. At the age of 48, Cameron says she's retired from acting, and she and Benji welcomed their daughter Radix in December 2019. Who knows if she'll change her mind and go back to starring in movies, but with a net worth of $140 million, she never needs to work again. Hey guys, it's Kara, and today we're bringing you another house tour here in Famous Entertainment. I noticed 95% of you watching aren't subscribed, so be sure to hit that subscribe button because we post a new video daily. And this one, we'll take a look at where Cameron Diaz and Benji Madden call home, like their main residence in LA, their New York condo, and more. If you like these videos, ring that bell for notifications. We've also done house tours on celeb couples like Sarah Michelle Gellar and Freddie Prinze Jr., and we'll link to some at the end. Follow me on Instagram to chat, and as usual, let me know whose house tour is next in those comments down below. Now let's get into this video. While it was reported a few years back that Cameron was letting go of her penthouse in New York City, it wasn't the only one she had. Her and Benji can enjoy the other condo that the former actress purchased in 2014. After being spotted scouting a few units in New York City's famed Walker Tower, Cameron officially shelled out over $9 million for a gorgeous unit in the coveted 1929 Art Deco building in Chelsea. The upscale 22-story tower is in the heart of Manhattan and offers 360 views of the city. The luxury unit Cameron bought spans 3,022 square feet with 3 beds and 3.5 baths, and all residences, including hers, have soaring ceilings and large tilt and turn windows. Cameron can also enjoy fabulous views of the Statue of Liberty and Freedom Tower from most everywhere in the home, and like more than half of the units here, she has private terraces where the perfect views continue outside. An insanely luxe kitchen here has a sub-zero refrigerator, an under-counter fridge freezer, and a wine cooler, as well as a top-of-the-line Viking oven unit, a built-in coffee maker, and water filter. All of the units here include radiant floor heating, oak floors, a smart home system, and marble bathrooms with steam showers and heated towel racks. Cameron's master suite boasts coveted southeast views and abundant closet space, while the other bedrooms also have ensuite baths. Aside from the sky-high purchase price, Cameron shells out over $2.7K per month for building amenities. These include a 24-hour doorman, concierge, library lounge with bar and pantry, refrigerated storage room for deliveries, fitness center with yoga room, sauna and rooftop deck with dining area, lawn and cabana room. In 2017, Cameron and Benji reportedly bought a modest house in Studio City, Los Angeles for $2.1 million, just over the hill from the Hollywood bustle. While they don't live here as their main residence, it was the first home they bought together, and it could have been an investment property if they aren't staying here much. The contemporary home was built in 1964 and updated since, spanning 2,483 square feet inside and tucked behind gates, offering canyon views. There are 4 beds and 4 baths within, as well as an indoor outdoor aesthetic and sleek design. A spacious driveway fronts the all-white exterior, while the great room has expansive windows and doors to lead outside. A marble fireplace grounds another sitting area, dividing the living and dining room. There's also a chef's kitchen with waterfall island and office full of natural light. Cameron and Benji's house has a light color palette throughout, but the powder room is much moodier. The master suite has a huge window showcasing the canyon views, while the attached bath has even a door to the backyard beside the glass shower. Outside on the grounds, there's a uniquely shaped pool and rolling lawns. Now let's move on to Cameron and Benji's main mansion. Back in 2010, Cameron bought a beautiful estate in the Beverly Hills post office area from actress Candace Bergen for $10 million. The 3-acre spread had a bit of an English country manor vibe inside, with vaulted ceilings and wooden beams, but since purchase, Cameron has extensively renovated the place. The home is located in the exclusive gated community of Hidden Valley, where Cameron and Benji's neighbors include Jennifer Lawrence, Nicole Kidman, and more. The compound is composed of a main villa that offers about 5,000 square feet of space with 3 beds and 4.5 baths, plus a detached guest house spanning 2,000 square feet with another 3 beds and 2 baths. At the time of purchase, Cameron's home had various rooms with hardwood, tile, and brick floors, as well as upholstered furniture and essentially just a cozy cottage feel throughout. There was a reading corner with views over the private community and an open plan living room with 2 seating areas right next to the dining room. Although Cameron and Benji are super private, you can bet that the home has been redesigned and is a lot more modern. In more recent news, Cameron added a 1-story family wing to her already sprawling mansion, likely to welcome her and Benji's growing family. You can see her add-ons from the various floor plans that surfaced. The expansive park-like grounds here haven't changed much over the years though, because it sounds like they were already perfect. Cameron has a freeform swimming pool and spa, brick dining terraces, vine-covered patios, lush gardens, a gazebo, tennis court, and more. For the mansion renovations, Cameron used the architect George de la Nuez, who also worked with Denise Richards to build her dream home and other Hollywood stars. During quarantine, we did get a look into Cameron and Benji's kitchen when Cameron whipped up a salad for an Instagram post, giving fans a sneak peek inside the home. By the looks of it, they have sleek wooden cabinets, marble countertops, and gold taps in an airy and modern space. Their kitchen also offers chef-grade appliances and plenty of space for Cameron to cook all her healthy meals. From what we can see, it appears while Cameron and Benji's home is super luxurious, it also has an earthy and homey vibe. So I think I'll bring this house tour to an end here. After seeing Cameron Diaz and Benji Madden's homes, what did you guys think? It seems like the couple has made the Beverly Hills estate into their dream home to raise their new daughter Radix, and couldn't be happier. And from what I can see, the place is gorgeous. Be sure to rate Cameron and Benji's homes in the comments down below, or pick your favorite of the 3. I also recently started a personal channel. I've been posting a lot of fun stuff over there, so if you want to get to know me a bit better, please go like and subscribe. We'll link you my latest video, and I even had a special guest in this one.
Fact, last weekend we survived off pizzas. We ordered too many, and I was eating it for 3 days, and then I got sick because all I ate was pizza.
Literally,
That's how much savory people we are.
And then we went and had pizza last night.
Oops.
All right, guys, thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and drop a comment for whose house tour you want to see next. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.